the seven deadliest sins. Don't forget they're within. Forget the seven sins of your Bible. Olvide los siete pecados de tu Biblia. They're not as reliable as you thought them. Ils ne sont pas ce que l'on croit. Trop sont endormis comme des zombies. Trop de condes et qui torturent des foncés au lieu des ordures que l'on sait. Qui font des abus sur des corps purs qui les décorporent. Et c'est pas encore sûr qu'on comprenne. Let me try to explain this as plainly as your ears can perceive it. The seven deadly sins are not what they appear to be. Pride in your origins, your work and your peoples is not a problem at all. It is a mark of confidence and assurance. You see, gluttony is not really something we should be too bothered from either. Nor is lust or sloth, those are all natural feelings. It's normal to be a human being and we are not our ideals. Our senses are our bodies. Wrath is also a part of us and who we are, even to God. What is peace without war? It is opposite to calmness. It can be fostered as militants. Watch down sets clips and listen attentively to the sound sent. Envy can be a problem, but so can a zealous zombie preaching tales of the gospels. The only true deadly sin of any that I've talked of in these seven is greed. You see it in Rockefellers and in legions of corporate felons and elitists. There's a reason they say money is the root of all evil, but it isn't money truly, it's greed. It rules all peoples from what we see and breathe to what we're deceived into believing is reasons and creeds that are treason. Let me tell you about the real seven sins that Christian heavens never listed. And this is no tall tale, it is not fiction. So mind them and listen attentively. Écoute attentivement, y'a tant de gens qui sont démentiels, qui démentent et qui mentent au nom du ciel, au nom du Père et du Fils et du Saint-Esprit. Mais où est la mère divine? On n'entend rien, pas de bruit à son propos. Tous ces idiots qui disent bitch si, putain ça, qui parlent de salopes et de garces, quand ce sont toutes des déesses. Mais quelle est cette farce réellement? What is this joke where men provoke women with ignorance and control them with belligerence and hold their chins up like their divinities? Here is the first sin of the seven, and this isn't a question, it's most definite. Ask most deaf if you wish it, he'll tell you what it is. Patriarchy is the name of this horror, and it controls the globe with its consorts, the seven heads of the beast. Misogyny is next, and it is the twin brethren of this leech, followed by queerphobia. Hollow souls revel in their weird opuses and call themselves noble and unquestionably blessed, like Christians promoting a bleached Jesus that's actually Cesar Borgia. Please read of this and ponder where he came from. He was a sannyasin and he didn't eat meat, he was a Rasta. That's the creed of Nazarenes. Ask the people of his region and seize this. This brings me to the fourth sin that needs to be dismembered and beheaded. That's religion and its sectarian divisions that preach peace but each speak like theirs is the only sensical. Disrespecting each and every is senseless. The cure and answer to this sickness is faith and spirituality, not knavish duality of good and evil. The fifth is a close kin to religion, it is ignorance. And never will he be blissful to anyone again after this yuga. For its sons, so many dungeon rulers that want to truly hunt and abuse all they view as useless. But they are the useless ones in truth, yes. Ignorance is also the root of many sins. It is the father to all of them. Like Yahweh, we are they call God, who is the cause of all of these monsters. Because of all the deities he demonized and tried to conquer with evil lies. But we see them with the eye that we breathe from in our mind. And we will not be confined any longer in this sickness. The sixth sin is abuse in all of its form, from physical to sexual, mental and spiritual, emotional, psychological and psychic. I specify it in all of its guises and likeness, so you can rise and enlighten and darken, and find the true heavens in the skies of the night goddess and hearken. And finally, the seventh is racism, also closely related to discrimination and bigotry, which are both kin to ignorance and senseless hatred. If you can't relate to this, you'll be lost in the marsh pit of your fates, yes. So many toxic cases of neo-Nazis and conservative fascists we clash with. They are the murderous madmen that actively hate for no active purpose, lacking creational worth, so they have to take it from the earth's first patrons, like Africans, Asians, and First Nations. But they are rabid and tainted, acrid and fake, and they will have to face this and nurture the sayings of mirth, rather than praying in churches and preying upon and cursing those that created daily worship. But it will not be long till this song is a mantra for the age that we're immersed in, and the seven deadly sins of the church are accepted to be as generally irrelevant as the purpose of the hellish sent curses against the melanin of persons, as elegant and eloquent as verses from an elephant-headed earthling, and a celibate Krishna resting with serpents. And a celibate Krishna resting with serpents.